Good morning. This week I saw Gina De Luca do a video about making feathers with a string, and that was very beautiful and I liked it so much that I decided to make a challenge of it in our Facebook group. And of course I need to participate myself also. The colors that I'm going to use for the background color, I'm using pearlized white, so that looks like a pearl or the inside of a shell when dried. I have a copper that is a little bit yellow, and I also have a copper that is more red, that's from Amsterdam. This is from Xenos, that's a Dutch store. And I also found that's called Halo Blue Gold. It's from Lumiere by Jacquard. And I thought I was actually buying alcohol ink, but it was not when it arrived. But it turned out to be a really beautiful acrylics. And it's, as you can see, a blue and green and gold all in one. So I will also use that. I have gold from Artesa. And I have the Mars Brown from Artesa. So that are the colors I'm going to use. First I will lay down my background color, the pearlized white. Not too much, because I tried one before and it's very hard not to when you pull the string to drag with you the whole background color. That's not what I was intended to do. Okay, well, I will cover this and I'll be back. Okay, I've actually laid down a very thin layer of the pearlized white. Now I'm blowing some air bubbles out with my creme brulee torch. You see, it's fire. And now I will lay down some colors on this piece of Yupo paper. I will start with a dark brown, then a little bit of the red copper. If you would like to know how I mix my paints, please see the eye in the upper corner and click on that, and then you can see how I mix my pour paint. Okay, now I will lay down my string. Make sure that it's really covered. It's just a piece of wool that you normally use to make scarves. Not scars, a scarf. Make sure that your string is really covered. But if you like to see how it's done really beautiful, please check Gina De Luca's YouTube channel. because she did a really, really beautiful job with her feathers. Okay. I'm trying to put down a straight line and now just pull it back. Now I just wipe off the paint with my fingers and put it back in the paint again. Again, make sure everything is covered. And lay it down and try to follow the same line again. And put it back. You see, you take down a lot of the background paint. And now I will lay this down and pull it all the way down. Yeah, that looks pretty. I have not covered the sides yet, but I will paint that also with the pearlescent white. And what we can do now is make the small furry feathers that's usually on the bottom of a feather. Well, these are some very pretty colors. I'm going to do one next to it. I'm getting a new string. I don't have Yupa paper anymore, but I want to do this only with the coppers and the brown. And a little bit of gold. And now with a stick, making sure that all is covered. Lay it down and pull it back. Wiping it off again. And dipping it in the paint again, making sure it's covered. I really like that coppers. Looks really beautiful. And put it down again in the same line. And pull it back again. Okay, and now put it down here and drag it in the middle to the bottom. Now I'm just making that same little fur feathers again. Please tell me what it's called. We call it dons. I don't know what it's called in English. Okay, now I'm going to do one more and then just use the dark brown and the blue, or the halo blue gold. Need another string again. And I will put the colors down here, so I hope you can see. No, I will do that. Let me see with the gold. And then just lay the string in, get it covered again. I'm sorry. I live in a very loud neighborhood. And I forgot to close my window. Okay. Putting it down. And pull it back again. Putting it down in the paint one more time, getting it covered. But now I will use a little bit of the dark brown, because both sides do not need to be exactly the same. Put it down again. And pull it back. And drag it down in the middle. I want to make this a little bit more in shape. Yeah, I love it very much. So thank you, Gina, for giving us such good ideas. Okay, well, I will give you a close-up.
Hey guys, I'm here for the close-up.
I hope I can show you how shiny all these pearl paints are and metallics. But I'm afraid I cannot catch it on camera. The white just looks like a pearly nail polish. Very pretty. And all the metallics are of course also very shiny. But I think it doesn't show on camera. But I will make some pictures or maybe a small video when it's dry. And maybe I can go outside and film it outside where there's much better lighting, of course. Okay, if you liked it, please give me your thumb up. Subscribe on my YouTube channel. Look for me on my Facebook or Instagram. I really like that. If you have questions, I will answer them. Okay, thank you for watching, guys, and see you next time. Bye-bye.